We finished last video finding this chained family of subsets of X that, in a way, were sort of dense. Now we will finally define the function that will give us Urysohn's lemma and prove that it's continuous. For this, we will define the set Qx for any element x in the space as the set of all the indexes p for which x is an element of up, where up were the sets that we defined in the previous video. So if you haven't checked that video, make sure you do. Now remember that when we defined this, we said that if p was smaller than 0, then up was going to be the empty set, and any element in the space is not an element of the empty set, so this set Qn is not going to have any rational number smaller than 0. And we also said that if p was greater than 1, then up was going to be the whole space, and obviously any element belongs in the space, and so we will have every p for p greater than 1. So if p is smaller than 0, then p is not in Q of x, and if p is greater than 1, then p will be an element of Q of x. So this tells us that the numbers we're going to focus now in Q of x are going to be between 0 and 1. And so what we will do is define this function f of x to be the infimum of Q of x. Obviously, f of x is greater than or equal to 0, because we don't have any element that's smaller to 0, and so 0 is a lower bound of Q of x. And also, f of x is going to be smaller than or equal to 1, because given that we have all the numbers that are greater to 1, the infimum of all those numbers will be 1 or smaller, but it will be always less than or equal to 1. Now let's see if f satisfies what we want in the theorem. For that, let's see what happens if we have x in A. And for this, it's a good idea to come back to this drawing. Now, if x is an element here in A, then it's an element in U0, it's an element in basically any set. And so the infimum over all the rational numbers that are between 0 and 1 is 0. So if x is in A, this infimum is going to give us 0. Great, because this is one of the things that we want. Now, if x is an element in B, then we are in this situation. Now we have an element here. The only time that we will be able to cover this set will be when we reach up equal to x, the entire space. And so x in B will be an element of up for every p greater than 1. And so the infimum will be 1. So f of x for x in B has to be 1. Again, this is great because it's what we wanted. Now we have to prove that f is continuous. But before doing this, let's prove a few facts that will be useful to prove the continuity. The first fact is that if x is an element in the closure of some ur for some rational number r, then f of x is going to be less than or equal to r. And the second fact is that if x is not an element in ur, then f of x is greater than or equal to r. Well, let's prove these two assertions. If we take x in ur, the closure, ur, we know the way we built these sets was so that ur was a subset of for every s that was greater to r. So for any s greater to r, x is an element of us. And so for all of these indexes, there will be elements in Q of x. And now just using the definition of an infimum gives us that the infimum will be R, or it could be smaller, because we don't know if X, maybe it was just in the closure of R, or if it was inside of R, and so it was in a even smaller subset. So, like this, we have f of x less than or equal to r. And now let's prove the second one. If x is not an element in ur, then because we have this, x will not be an element in us for any s smaller now to r, because all these sets are subsets of ur. And so the infimum, it cannot be smaller than s. So the infimum has to be greater than or equal to r. So that was very simple, just a few facts about this function f. And now we are ready to prove that this function is continuous. For this, we'll use the usual definition of continuous, that is, the preimage of an open set is an open set. So what we will do is consider some fixed element in the interval 0, 1 and an open neighborhood AB of x0. What we will do is prove that there exists some set U in the topology of X such that F of U is a subset of the set AB. And proving this will prove that F is continuous. But we have to define this set U, and all we know in our space is that we have this sort of density with some subsets. So we can take advantage of the fact that here we're working on the 0, 1 and just choose P and Q, rational numbers, such that A is smaller than P, smaller than F of X0, smaller than Q, smaller than B. So P and Q are two rationals here that determine another neighborhood of X0. Now, because we have rational numbers, we have their corresponding sets UP and UQ. So let's define the set U to be UQ minus the closure of UP. Remember that this closure was contained in UQ. Well, let's see if this set U satisfies this that we want to prove. Well, first of all, this set is closed because it's the closure of any set, and so U is open. Now let's see that this element X0 is an element of U. For this, we'll use the contrapositive of these two facts here. We'll use that if f is less than r, then x is an element in ur, and if f of x is greater than r, then x is not in the closure of ur. Because of the contrapositive, we have that f of x 0 is smaller than q. We have this from the p and q that we graphed, and so because it's smaller than q, that means that f of x0 is an element in uq. And now the contrapositive of 1 gives us that because p is smaller than f of x0, then f of x0 is not in the closure of up. And so from these two things, x0 is in uq, but is not in up. So we have that x0 is in U. Now we want to prove that f of U is a subset of this interval AB. For this, let's take some element x in U. From this, we have two things. First, that x is an element in UQ. And because it's an element in UQ, then we have the first property. It would give us that it's in UQ closure, and so f of x is smaller than q. So x is in UQ, it's also in its closure, and so this is because of 1, f of x is smaller than or equal to 1. But we also get, because it's an element in U, that is not in the closure of UP. From this, the second property tells us that f of x is greater than or equal to p. And here it was q. So f of x is between p and q. But p and q were two numbers chosen so that this interval was a subset of AB. And so we have exactly what we wanted. And like this, we get that our function f is continuous. And this proves Urysohn's lemma. So with this, we finish the two videos where we proved one of the most important theorems in topology.